What do NBSAPs have to do with preventing ecological collapse? First, what's an NBSAP? It's not a spaceship. It's a National Biodiversity Strategy and Action Plan. Basically, a country's plan for nature. It lists what will be protected, what will be restored, and how we'll make sure it's all used wisely. It's like a to-do list for living systems, but it's more than a list. It's accountability. It's a promise in writing that a country intends to keep its word. When the world agrees to something ambitious, like conserving 30% of Earth by 2030, NBSAPs are where that ambition meets a spreadsheet. And because biodiversity isn't just birds and trees, these plans weave nature into decisions across government and reflect the need for action that spans communities, businesses, and beyond. Everyone whose work depends on the natural world, which in the end is everyone. In 2022, nearly every country signed onto the Global Biodiversity Framework, a collective plan to stop the nature crisis. Under it, each country agreed to update its NBSAP. So far, 55 have. That leaves 141 to go. Some are fine-tuning. Others need more resources and capacity to put them together. But the clock is ticking, because the targets are bold, from how we protect and restore nature to how we produce, consume, and invest. So, what do NBSAPs have to do with preventing ecological collapse? Pretty much everything. They are how we move from talking about saving nature to actually doing it.